His clever name, his clever name, Mad Blunts and Bong Blast. Clever name podcast, fucked up shit to make your mom laugh.
You're fucked.
Never really know what you gon' get. Might catch a buzz from the contact. Lots of that disgusting discussion. Loving it cause it's funny. We got topics for the rich. Poor, gorgeous, and ugly. We got guests of all shapes and sizes. Outrageous violence. If you home alone, then don't try this. Clever name podcast is where you find us.
Hello, welcome back. The fucking core group back at it for two more weeks, I think. That's what it is. No Artie. I don't know. He's like a day laborer, so it's like hit.
He's a day laborer.
Sorry, Carlos. I'm gonna bleep that. I don't know if he actually like. I have no idea
if he dislikes like, it or.
I just can't.
I feel like he doesn't care.
I feel like it's like a nickname is Artie, and he just like. But to be like never bring that up, like to never ever just go like, "Yep, I'm Artie," and just never bring up that he has whatever. It's a weird start to it. Back to the core group, Blake, Martin, me, we're all here. If you want to interrupt the show, you can do it with TTS now. I'm waiting for somebody to do that, to just spam N-words, and it's going to be embarrassing, but there will be a moment that
you
happens.
You have a kill switch.
Nope.
Not yet.
I'm waiting for until I need it. I'm going to give somebody the courtesy of at least fucking with us for a little bit.
At least, yeah.
I'm sure I can figure it out on the fly, but it's going to take a minute. It's going to take like a couple seconds.
Like, oh shit.
And it's just going to be like bleep, bleep, bleep. But, yeah. So if you feel like doing that there's a button right underneath the stream where you can interrupt us at any moment and it could be a disaster. But I apologize if you can hear the air conditioner that's pumping in the background because over the course of this week, I've had a hell of a week. Last week during the podcast, my air conditioner unit just died. And it got hot, and it's gotten more hot, and it might be the hottest point of the summer this week.
It is. This week's supposed to be like the hottest week we've ever had.
Yeah, this is a long weekend, and it said coming into the long weekend, it's probably going to be 40 degrees, which is like 100 degrees if you're American. Yeah. Like, it's fucking unbelievably hot. So, and my house is sweltering, so I had to go get a wall air conditioner, like a window air conditioner, and it's bumping in the back right now. So it's the only, if I open this door behind me, it's like the Sahara Desert coming in, and we are in the only cold room in this house. So I apologize.
You're wearing pants. Like,
I always wear pants.
I don't think I actually have ever seen you wear shorts.
One time, people made fun of me in high school because one time we had a beach party in the middle of the afternoon and I biked there and I came in jeans, didn't bring shorts.
Is that the only reason they made fun of you?
No, probably like the autism and stuff too. Like probably.
But you showed up to the beach in jeans?
Jeans. Yeah, I biked there in jeans.
Pretty autistic.
No shorts. I wasn't planning on swimming and I only wear jeans. So I was like, I'm just going to a beach party. I'm going to hang out and it's going to get cold later. I'm always cold too. Everybody shut the fuck up. Let me wear my jeans. Stop judging me. I don't understand. Why can't I just wear jeans?
You only wear shorts while camping.
I did, yeah. Camping's like at
did
a
you
certain.
Wear shorts when we went camping?
I probably did. At a certain point, I'll wear a wife beater and shorts camping. That'll be the only time
I think you were in a tank top.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I'll do. It's called a wife beater, please. Yeah. Thank you.
No, that's specifically a white tank top, though.
It's true. White power. But it's like, it's something about camping where it's just eventually it gets to me. Like, and that's too hot where I'm just standing out in the sun for where it's like 35
and
degrees.
You can just feel the humidity.
Yeah, and I'm like in a tent, too. Like, or if it starts to rain, too, and then you're stuck in a tent. And I'm like, yeah, I'm just going to wear shorts. I'll just rock my underwear if I could. Like, I just fucking walk around naked
that's
in the
good.
Forest. Yeah, let's do Naked and Afraid, but public park edition.
But at a provincial park.
That is a like way a more dangerous game.
You have to
avoid the rangers. That's your main. Yeah, you think the wildlife the problem. The dude on the ATV who's hunting you down is going to be a big issue. So you're going to have to get
a random horse last time we went camping.
Wait, what?
Remember the fucking random horse neighing in the background when we went camping?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It was just off in the fucking distance. We're like, did you just hear a horse?
Oh, yeah.
Like, wow, how fucking high are we? And then you hear it again, and you're like,
no, one of us heard it, and no one believed them.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
It might have been me. I think it was me that said it. Somebody, I don't remember who and if it was me, but I remember somebody going, that's did you guys just hear a horse? And everyone was like, no. And what? I think it was me because I remember feeling crazy and getting all worked up and panicky like I do. I'm like, no, I definitely heard a horse. Like, and then we waited a while again, and then somebody else heard it and confirmed it. I'm like, see? Get all high-pitched.
It's just so random because it was like off in the distance. You just hear a horse, and you're like,
Yeah, and it goes, what the fuck? You're like, what the fuck? Like, is it just going to come down the street? And I remember when there's, like, a guy, like, in, I guess, your town now. I moved. But that just walks a horse.
The mini pony?
Yeah, he's got a mini pony. Just walks it downtown.
Yep.
Nobody cares. He's just,
I've
like.
I've seen him on, like, the, like, Ann Bridge and shit. And it's just like, fuck.
Yeah.
Where do you get a mini? Where, like, why do you have a mini pony?
Why not?
Free grass cutting, I guess.
Where do you keep them in, like, a city?
No, I've seen him where he lives. He has them pegged up out front of his house in down, like, a downtown area. Yeah. Oh my God. It's just pegged up in front of his house, and then it's just eating the grass. And I'm assuming that's what he, like, never has to cut his lawn. Pretty solid. But, so, my air conditioner broke. And then we actually pay for like a monthly subscription thing so they can come out here and fix it and we don't have to pay for anything. It's like a thing you can pay with like your furnace company and shit. And so we pay for that. So they come out really quickly. They're like, hey, like let's come out. Mm-hmm. And so they come out and they send a small, tiny white woman who out of all of the HVAC repair people that I've ever seen, I've never seen such a dainty, cute person come here to. And I was like, it's not getting fixed. I don't know if that's sexism or whatever. It ended up being correct. So whatever it is, it's also correct. So whatever you want to label it, is the end result. Because she goes like, there's like an issue with the motor. And first of all, they sent one person immediately. And they're like, he diagnosed it immediately. He was like, yeah, it's the motor. We don't have the part. We need to send it in. So they have to wait a couple of days and they mail it in. When it shows up, then they send the little lady to put in the motor. Yeah. And she can't get the fan blade off. Like, she's like, it's seized up, like, I can't do it. And I was like, I went out there, like, I didn't want to do it. I should have. It just felt wrong, because I'm like, you're the expert here, and I know nothing about HVAC repair. And I went out there after she left, and it's not seized. You could get it right off. Like, it's really not that hard. But the motor is hanging out of it, not connected, and I don't know how to connect all that piece. So, like, I could fix it if she just finished the motor, but she didn't. And she was out there for so long talking to herself, making phone calls. And then Crystal pointed out that, like, I don't know, like, this is a vibe that I get when your repair person comes out and you can see their jumpsuit is like 35 years old. It's sun beaten. It's not the right color that it should be. You're like, this guy's
fucking, he's fixing your problem.
Yeah, he's got it. He knows what it is before he's even started. He's already solved it. This lady, brand new uniform, like spotless. Actually, you could see the creases where she took it out of the package. And I was like, nah. Crystal pointed it out, and she was like, it wasn't like sun damage, like she's been sitting out in the sun for hours fixing air conditioners. It was brand new. And I was like, ah, damn it, they sent a new person out. So I was like, wonderful. So then she's like, yeah, sorry, I can't fix it, we need to send another part. So then they send another part, and then they're like, okay, there's supposed to be somebody coming today. And then like, yeah, no, we don't have anybody today. So I was like, wow. Okay, so now it's tomorrow. So eventually, I had to go get this goddamn air conditioner.
They
so now I'm
new diversity hire in. And
yeah,
they can fucking fix it.
We're literally coming to that world. Like, all of that is finally hitting full tilt, where diversity hires have like taken over, and now it's just like equality over productivity, and now it's starting to affect things.
Yeah,
it's why you don't want to buy new stuff. Like, you seriously,
don't buy new stuff?
Yeah, like. A brand new car, like a 2023, is probably going to be an issue. Yeah. I'm going to say, yeah, because they hired somebody that was underqualified who did all of their testing during COVID. Like, the guy was trained during COVID on a Zoom meeting to build a car. Like, that doesn't seem like it's going to work out well. It's just like,
connect the red wire. And
no, he's just got a hot he's got a Hot Wheel at home and with a diagram. And he's like, hopefully this will translate to real life. And now those cars are coming into the market now, and I wouldn't buy them, is what I'm saying. Anything that was probably in production over the last 3 or 4 years, just avoid it. You got to go in 2018 and past to be safe at this point. So, yeah, that was part of my week. Then, so Crystal's had this issue ever since she's been to the hospital, not just that she's had a seizure and, you know, it's fucked, but she's been complaining about the vein in her arm that she's had, she had the IV in. And did she get you guys to feel it last week?
No.
She told me about it.
Did she tell you about it?
Today.
So.
No, what?
The vein in, like, where they put the IV in is, like, hard. Like, rock hard. Like, she's got a boner in her vein. And it's been like that. She was like,
Did you guys go get that checked out?
Well, yeah, but she was like thinking it was because she was thrashing around and maybe like there's like scar tissue in her vein or something like that.
Probably made a fucking clot.
Yeah, like it made some sort of issue in her vein, and we're like, oh, well, that's an issue, but like we tell them and they're like, oh, well, you'll just have to go to the emergency room and figure it out. And we're like, I guess so. We have to like wait there for 9 hours. And then Crystal's just like, well, let's just see, like maybe it's just bruised and it'll go down.
Yeah.
So we waited for like a week and nothing changed. Nothing's changed other than the bruising around it did go down. Like the bruising from like them jamming the needle in a million times, 'cause she kept ripping it out, like had gone down and it looked like it's gotten better.
Why did you keep taking it out?
Didn't I explain this before? She's retarded. But she, like, when she was all drugged up, she was, like, violent with everybody. Like, she was so strong.
Oh,
when,
really?
Like, when she, like, gave her all these drugs to calm her down, and she would fight everything in the most polite way, like, aggressively fight you. Way. She would say, like, please and thank you and stuff like that while she's, like, throwing hands.
I was gonna say, while she's throwing haymakers.
Yeah. She's literally like, can you please get off me? Please get off me. And like she's like ripping her IVs out and stuff, and they had to keep putting it out. They had to like retape it a billion times. Oh, and it was all swollen and bruised and fucked up. And so we thought, like, it's not normal, but we're like, it wasn't a normal situation. This wasn't a normal IV. You kept fucking with it over and over again. So nothing changes over the course of a week, and we're like pretty convinced they left a piece of IV in there. We're like 90% sure that there's like a piece of, because you can feel it. And it like tapers, and there's like an end to it, like where the like the threaded part would be. Like you can feel, like it was.
You should fucking look into that.
Yeah, wanted to. So went to the. She had to get an MRI the other day, and I'm like, do not get the MRI until they check out what the fuck is in your arm.
Yeah.
It could be a hunk of metal that, and when you go into the machine, you're going to blow up the whole hospital. Like, don't, like, not only you are going to die, the whole ward is going to die. Like, don't let them do that. And they're like, oh, well, we can test if it's metal. And they do, they like hold a magnet to it and they go, nope, you're good. So like, yeah, go have your MRI. I was like, no, insist that they take it out. And she's like, no, they say there's nothing they can do. Like, they're just MRI techs. And I'm like, well, get a fucking doctor there to take the thing out of your arm. They're like, yeah, they confirm that it's a foreign object in her arm, but there's nothing they can do. We just need to do the MRI. And then you have to, like, schedule an appointment to get it out. We're like, I'm like, no, they left a thing in your arm.
Yeah, they
like,
fucked
this is,
up and left something in your arm.
There's medical equipment left in your arm by these people. Don't just go, like, to the back of the line. That's not how it works. Yeah. Think about, like, at a fast food restaurant when, like, they forgot one of your order. The person cuts in front of all the people that are waiting because they were first and you fucked up. You were already here and this shouldn't be a problem.
Yeah.
You should be at the front of the line. The triage system, unless there's somebody immediately dying of a gunshot wound, you should be next in line because they fucked up. Get it out of your arm. And they're like, no, well, unfortunately we don't have a doctor. I was like, you should be fucking losing your mind. And Crystal is just like, okay. Like, she's like, I'm like, I don't know what to do because they wouldn't let me in. And now there's all these mask policies and shit, and I'm losing my mind. It's fucking late at night, and I was screaming. I was going to fight somebody. I was literally going to fight hospital employees if they would let me in. But they were very mask heavy, and I'm like, I'm not doing this. I'm just leaving before I get you kicked out and you don't even get any service. So I walked out and I sat in the parking lot while she was just going, okay, well, as soon as you can, I guess. Like, when you get around to removing the medical waste that you left in my arm, that'd be cool. And she sat there. An hour goes by, nobody comes. 2 hours go by, nobody comes. More people come in, they get served, nobody comes. We went there at about 10, or no, she started like at the emergency room. It was just before 10 when we made it after the MRI and yada, yada. It was about 10. Now it's like 1 in the morning and nobody's seen her. And we're like, I'm like, go and do this. So she goes up and she goes, do you have the information for the medical malpractice information? Like, I would like the number for that. And all of a sudden, people started to come to check on her.
Yeah.
People started to look into the thing, and they really, really, really started to downplay it. They're like, oh, yeah, this happens all the time. But when she talked to the person who checked her in, they're like, she's an old lady who's worked there for, like, 30 years. She's like, I've never heard of anything like this. Because it's not normal for them to leave stuff inside of you. This isn't a Seinfeld episode. It's real life. They should check that, probably. Be like, okay, all the stuff is out of your arm. You're good to go. That's all it took was just to like do a little tapsy on the wrist and then they would have been like, oh, that feels like there's some stuff in there. Let's get that out. Well, there's already a hole before it already heals up.
Is that what the big fucking bandage on her arm is? Mm-hmm. Was they had to take it out?
Yep. So they eventually, 3 o'clock in the morning now, get surgery in her arm eventually. So they cut it open, they fold her arm back, and they have to go into the vein and pull the piece of plastic out that's in her fucking arm. And there's like fat, like there's fat accumulated around it. Like it's creating a stint or like a reverse of a stint, like a blockage from the plastic, because it's all the fat that goes through your blood is catching on the plastic and it's built like she could have there. This could have been way more severe.
Yeah. I kept him fucking off.
Yeah. Well then come in and close the door.
Okay. I got to close the door.
Yeah.
Corrections to the story.
Okay.
The doctor that cut me open and did an exploratory surgery is what they call that. Oh, they're trying to figure out what there is. I sent you some pictures if you wanted to show everyone.
Jesus. Nice.
He was just finishing his shift and he had been there for 12 hours already and he was a younger doctor. Okay. An older doctor comes in and says, like, why is there so many nurses in here? Why is there so many people? What's going on?
Yeah.
And they said, we're like doing an exploratory surgery because we believe there's a piece of an IV line stuck in her. And then the seasoned doctor asked to see the x-ray and the ultrasounds. And he like points at it. He says there's a little metal circle on the x-ray and says like, that's what we're looking for. And then the doctor turns to me and says, did the technician doing the x-ray put a marker on you, like a sticker? And I was like, yeah, like a little metal sticker on me. And then the doctor just literally turns to the other one and goes, yeah, you're digging for a marker that's from an x-ray sticker that isn't in her arm. Oh my God. Then we all look at the x-ray, and then he goes, go to the next x-ray, and we look at the x-ray, and there's nothing in my arm. And then the other doctor brings the ultrasound machine, and he goes, fills over top, and he's like, yeah, I don't think there's anything inside her arm. I think that her vein is inflamed because she probably had something violent happen to her. And I said, I had a seizure. And then that doctor said, well, she probably had a seizure while they had the IV in her line. So holy, it's probably fuck, her vein is inflamed, and you've cut her open for no reason. So now you need to make sure that you give her a tetanus shot because you've been exploring inside her arm.
Oh my fucking God.
And then he said, you see that? And the doctor says to me, look, if you're not squeamish, look over. And I look, here's my arm. Yeah. And I look over and he says, like, that little like fatty stuff is, no, he says that red stuff you see is just fatty tissue. And I said, what did you call me? And then everybody started laughing and that was it. That was the end. They stitched me up.
Yes, they cut open this hole in her arm.
Oh, and I didn't get a picture of it, but they had the scissors attached to my arm and then
pulling it open like Predator style.
Yeah, so I could see the yellow fat, and it was like very squishy. It looks like a brain.
Yeah.
Like, inside like my arm.
So wait, they like didn't pull anything out of your arm?
They didn't pull anything out of my arm.
I thought you said they did.
No, they said to come back the next day because they want to double check that there's nothing else in my arm.
Shut the fuck up. So we might not be done with this shit. There might be something in your arm.
You had a really rough night and you were stuck on the highway and then you didn't want to.
So you didn't even tell me?
I called my grandma and cried over everything.
You didn't even tell me?
I came, so he came home last night and he was pissed.
Oh, I'm so pissed.
Like an hour and a half to get home.
Just the way that you're so nonchalant about all this shit happening. You're like, oh, I guess, like, whatever. I'm so angry because I'd be losing my fucking mind in there.
I did get the bill from the hospital for the ambulance ride too today.
What?
Yeah, it's not free.
Ambulances are not free.
They're $45 a ride.
Yep.
Okay.
Crutches are also like $100.
Whatever.
Crutches?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're fucking expensive. I kept my pair from when I broke my leg because there's two in our.
I didn't have the capability to take you into the fucking hospital, so $45 is a steal. It's actually probably less than an Uber there.
Probably. But one doctor thought there was something in it, another doctor thought there wasn't, and some of the nurses. So the younger nurses were like, is this something that happens all the time? And the younger doctor's like, yeah, I've seen this before. I was a doctor in the U.S. And like, yeah, I've seen it in private and public practices where like things are left inside of you. And one of the other nurses comes in and says, yeah, I have a C-section clamp right here. It's still stuck inside me from when they took my baby out. Do you want to feel? And like puts her fucking vagina over towards me and says, hey, feel this clamp. And I'm like, no. Oh,
fucking God.
Welcome to Soldiers Memorial, everyone. But yeah, so.
What the fuck? I go to that hospital instead of going to the one in Barry, because the wait time's better.
It is better because it's a smaller hospital, but like they treat the ER kind of like a walk-in clinic because like a guy came in with like, a drunk guy came in with like an ear infection. He got his prescription before I got shit cut out of my arm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I don't know. I don't
so I guess the moral of the story is we still don't fucking know if there's shit in her arm because it feels like there's definitely shit in her arm.
So the, once the young doctor left and the nurses left, the older doctor said to me, it's really common that, like, people who have very thin skin and light skin have very delicate veins, so you most likely just have an inflamed vein. But if they did leave something in you, you would call public records, and you would find out the nurse that inserted your IV, and, like, this would be the number that you would call to see if there's something that needs to be looked into, if there is anything that was left inside you.
Like that fucking nurse losing their job?
So,
God damn.
Oh, it was a brand new nurse.
So,
she was fucking brand new.
Yeah. Really?
It was a diversity hire. It was a small Indian lady who fucking.
Yeah, she was so nice.
She was absolutely sweet, but she had no idea what she was doing. It was a shit show.
I was by myself and I started to cry, and she would like wipe my tears. I would, no cry, no cry, Crystal, no cry. Yeah, it was really cute, actually. That's what she said to me. That's the only thing that I can really remember.
Wait, what did she say?
No cry, Crystal, no cry. But
no cry.
Oh, and they over medicated me because they put me on three different things for like the same thing.
Yeah, they gave her like a fuck ton of Ativan, and then she was fucked for days because of it. Like, it was nuts. They just, because she was so violent, they were just throwing the kitchen sink at her. They're just shoving handfuls of pills down her throat.
They're just like, yeah, calm down.
Every time they would come in,
kind of like every once in a while, I'm like jittery and it like jolts, and like I like feel it like coming at me.
They would just give her this cup, like she was like in the psych ward, a cup filled with a ton of pills, and she would just slug them back. I'm like, what is all this stuff? Excuse me, what is she taking?
I remember her saying, this might be hard to swallow. And I was like,
yep, she just, oop.
And I was
she's
like,
a champion like that. She's really good at it.
Yeah, did you not question that? Like, were you
what,
like,
how good of swallowing? No, I know.
What fucking pills were in this cup?
Like, I was, but like the quickness onto where I registered that she even had pills in her hand to when they were in her belly was so fast. They were still describing.
Like, I don't feel so good. Then I start sticking my finger to my throat, apparently.
Yeah, and then she just threw them all up. So I'm like, whatever. At least she'll be thin at the end of this.
Oh. Good guys, it's good.
But
not eating for 4 days is great.
But yeah, so like it was before, while she was still describing what the pills were, they were like down the hatch.
Yeah.
I can see why they thought we were drug addicts.
I just know how to swallow pills. I've had a lot of medical problems. Sorry.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah.
And they were like, when I went to get the MRI, so I had an MRI, x-rays, and an ultrasound and surgery yesterday.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. And we still
I tried to go back to work, so I worked for 7 hours.
But so they're just digging. Fainted, so they're just digging in your vein. That was it. They just dug in your vein, and
they were digging through the fatty tissue above the vein.
But the thing is going to be in the vein
because there was no blockage of blood flow, so there's nothing stuck in the vein. Is what the other doctor explained to the doctor who had his knife still inside my arm. And it I was so numb wrong. And so loopy because it was like 2 o'clock in the morning. I'd been up since 8 or 8.
And they probably drugged the fuck out of you before they
didn't give me any drugs other than they put, they're like, do you want us to freeze it? And I was like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah. And then they were like, okay. So then they had this needle that was like bent and like really long, and they stuck it down and into my arm. Like,
yeah,
really
like
far.
Hooks?
Yeah, it's got a hook on it. Yeah. And then I just felt this hot feeling, and then everything went cold and numb, including my life.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
It was a fucking nightmare, and I don't want to go back there ever again.
I mentioned we bought a house 2 months ago. It's been a little rough, and our central air unit's broken.
Yeah, we've already gone through it.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Fuck. And the cat ran away, and your dog lost.
Did you tell them about my parents in the hospital?
No. Oh, yeah. When she was all drugged up, her parents had got her to transfer her money.
Oh my
transfer God. The money.
Everyone in my family, actually. Long story short, they messaged every single person in my family telling them that I was in the hospital and they needed gas money to get to me. And they cleaned up and they got a couple $100 from everyone.
They almost,
they were already in the hospital with me.
They almost made it so we couldn't afford our mortgage because Crystal transferred money to them. Like, the timing was so bad that they transferred the money relatively close to when our mortgage payment is going to come out of that account. Oh, and then
I didn't know because I didn't remember at the time. So then when I went through my bank and was wondering why that money was missing. Like, where did it go?
And I kept wondering why they kept kicking me out of the room. Like, they were like, hey, do you mind if we just talk? To-? And I'm like, okay. Like, I'm just like, whatever. I guess they just want to talk, or like, they don't want to cry in front of me.
They told me he went home to shower.
I never left. I just kept, I just kept leaving the room.
When I woke up and they were asking me to use my phone, or like, could I send them some money for gas? Because they're going to go home and then they're going to come back for me. They said, asked them to watch me because you went home to shower and let the dogs out. And that's when I e-transferred them. It started, the more that the drugs come out of my system, the more and more I remember. So then I called my grandma and I told her everything, my mom's mom. And she was like, wait, they called me that day and I transferred the money. And then she's like, wait a second. Your aunt called me.
That's the kind of world we're living in right now. Everything is just falling downhill and I have no idea. Whatever.
All right.
We get it. We get it. Thank you. I appreciate for the clarification.
Still not definitive.
Yeah, no. We're still not definitive. Could have plastic, could have shrapnel in her arm. No idea.
Stitches. I don't know if the stitch is permanent. He said, we're just going to put one in you because we're going to bring you back for a sonic ultrasound.
And Poncho got out yesterday while I was at work. And Poncho like somehow escaped. Runs down the street. He's fucking gone. Like, he's sprinting. And Crystal's like, I have to go. She's on the phone with her sister. And just starts sprinting down the street. Her stitches rip open because she's sprinting after Poncho and starts leaking out her arm. The old ladies that live around us are trying to help her. They're like, oh, let's help the poor bleeding lady.
Over there that's 80 years old comes running this way. She's like, I'll go this way, Crystal. And like, runs the other way. And then Poncho sees her and he's like, oh, and he runs towards her. So then they end up on the ground and grab the dog.
Yeah, she's slide tackling a dog. Well, after she just got out of surgery,
this old guy's watching me and he's like, oh, he's fast. I'm like, fuck off, you could have picked him up.
Yeah. So that's how my week's been going.
His week.
Yeah. She doesn't even care. No, don't act like you care now because the whole time we're in the fucking hospital. Okay, well, I guess you left some stuff in. Mind getting it out?
I don't care at all. I'm too medicated.
You mind picking up the stuff you left?
The bedroom closet soon. I don't give a fuck anymore.
You're going to kill yourself?
Probably. Who cares?
I care.
Wait for the life. No, wait.
I'll make you more Halloween decorations.
If you kill yourself, do I get the life insurance?
Yes, but I have to wait 6 months. Okay, I tried.
Okay. No. Not allowed to talk about this. We're all done. We're good. Because if you do kill yourself, now it seems like a plan. Stop.
Oh, right.
Stop. I want the money.
Okay.
Okay, we're good. Thank you for the clarification.
I'm gonna go so he doesn't lose my life insurance. Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, it's so... Smells like hot shit out. Good. Anyway, let's move on from that.
What's wrong with your life?
I don't know.
What the fuck's going on?
I don't know.
Have you like tried praying for forgiveness?
It might have been when we...
Have you repented?
We have to uncurse Ryan next episode.
Okay.
It's the lump.
Wait. Can we plan something for next week? Can we try to do something? It is Blake's like last week here.
Yeah.
So let's try to do something big.
Bust out the Ouija board.
Let's bust it. Maybe not the Ouija board because Blake will get all iffy. Blake's butthole gets real tight when we bust out the Ouija board.
The Ouija.
Wait, what if we spell it differently? Martin came up with a different spelling, which I approved, which is W-E-E-G-E-E. What if we made a Ouija board?
A Ouija board?
It's a Ouija.
No.
Ouija.
Is this really a GIF debate right now?
No, it's going... Go, Weegee.
What? Giraffe?
Weegee.
Giraffe?
Weegee.
What's your defense? Did I just checkmate you with one?
Still Weegee.
But sometimes giraffe.
And it's still GIF.
It's A-E-I-O-U and sometimes giraffe.
And sometimes giraffe.
Yeah, that's what it is. So sometimes G's make G sounds.
Doesn't that make...
G.
Oh, so what the fuck did you just say? You just had
G makes G sound. J. G. J. 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 G. 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 So we G.
We.
Literally the letter G.
We.
Letter G. How does that work for you?
Letter G.
Mr. fucking stickler over here. Do you call it a fucking GIF too?
No, a GIF.
I just don't. So a GIF. It's GIF, and isn't it actually GIF? Doesn't the guy actually, like, the guy who made it?
No fucking idea.
Isn't it, like, graphics? So, it'd be... I don't fucking care. How did we get down this? It's a Ouija board. But anyway, what if... I remember we said this, we were going to do this a while ago, but then Artie had it. And then so we didn't actually follow through. Get the Death Note book, write lump in it, smash it with the fucking with the Death Note book while we all wear robes and light candles. Like we play like some ominous
Lump and Ryan's bad luck.
There we go.
Yeah. And just fucking douche.
And then we like oh, we do like a fucking what's that thing that the Skyrim. Skull and Crossbones Society or like whatever the
Seance?
No, what is those people? Bohemian Grove. Like that's the it's like the place it's what Nixon called the faggiest thing he's ever seen in his life.
Yeah.
Or the most faggoty thing. I think that's what it faggoty, which I really appreciate the word faggoty. It's like, it feels fun and uplifting, but it's not.
Those faggoty things.
It's like a good adverb or an adjective. Like,
faggoty.
What do you think of Blake? Real faggoty.
Thank you.
Thank you. And so I think we maybe do that. Maybe we can all get like hooded robes. like we're in like a cult and then like
what
play.
Color?
I was thinking like black and red. I don't know why. Vampire-y.
CMP colors?
Is that purple and yellow, green and yellow, and
purple, green, yellow.
Purple, green, and yellow. I don't know what those are our official colors. Those are terrible combinations. It's gonna be very hard to make a
Power Ranger, man.
I know it's gonna be hard to make a good looking robe out of purple, yellow, and green. But just say we get some robes, put on some hood, play some creepy music, and
that sounds interesting. You want to get some robes with hoods?
Yeah, let's all get hooded robes that cover our identity so we can say what we want to say.
Perfect.
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe we can start a clan?
Faggoty.
A faggoty clan. It's a real faggoty idea, in all honesty. But I think that that's a great idea. I think you just fucking, you smack it with the Death Note lump and you add in. It's like it's like how politicians add little pieces into the end of good deals. It's like free candy for everyone plus communism. Yeah. And they like add that in at the end. That's what we do. It's like get rid of the lump plus all the goddamn bad luck that's happening to Ryan.
Plus bad luck.
Plus curse. Plus whatever. Oh yeah, there was like a witch who'd speak Latin to me and spit in my mouth. Do you think that could be it?
Maybe.
I didn't think that was related, but yeah, I bumped into her on the street. She spit in my mouth and said something.
She's like,
and I was like, I don't know. She
the
had like
fucking
a
sky went gray.
It was three witches. They shared an eye. It was very. They had a cauldron. They were trying to defeat Hercules.
One of these.
What's that?
It's the cornuto, the Italian thing to ward off evil spirits.
I think that's just the devil horns.
Oh, it might be this one. I don't know. It's one of these.
That's Spider-Man.
No, it is.
Thumb in is Satan.
Dio made this into the metal thing.
Yeah.
It's an old Italian thing to ward off fucking evil spirits.
Oh, yes. Ah. Yeah, like the horn thing or
and
whatever.
And then this is Spider-Man. Okay.
Dio made this into the metal thing.
Oh, so before?
Before metal.
And Satan took it back?
Yes.
What you're saying?
Yes.
All right. Well.
So before metal era and after metal era?
Yeah.
I guess.
Got it.
So if I just do this, I'll have good luck?
Apparently.
Is that what's going to happen? So I just keep.
You're not Italian, so it might not work for you, so I don't know.
That's this.
Fucking pasta. No,
you
got
you do that. You give them the fagula.
Make some pasta.
Fucking pasta and pizza.
You give them the fucking gabagool. Hey, you motherfucking spirit. Hey, I'm fucking you. Come over here. You come into my mouth. I smack you in the motherfucking face. Hold on. I'll give you an offer you cannot refuse, demon. You get the fuck out of my life and you curse Blake. He's leaving. He can't bring it back. Take that shit over to the island of PEI. I need the... I'll give you the offer you can. You come to me on the day of my daughter's wedding. I think I just crossed like 7 movies. It's had an Italian stroke. I taste Parmesan. But,
it smells like burnt pasta.
That's a stroke. Yeah. That's an Italian stroke.
Is that burnt lasagna? Oh, shit.
Who's burning linguine? I don't... okay, so if you've been living under a rock, you understand that Manscaped made one of the biggest mistakes of their life by sponsoring this podcast.
They're fucked.
They gave us... We're all wearing matching shirts like fagools.
Faggoty, man.
That's what it says on the back.
Faggoty.
But yeah, I'm sure they're going to love that. Don't send that part to them. But like, it takes balls to sponsor somebody like this or very low research value and just taking our word for it. So
he reached out to you though.
They did. Honestly, we didn't even reach out. I don't know how they got our contact information. They're just like, just being around.
Name website.
That's fucking awesome.
I know. So they've sent us stuff. We're working on some videos and stuff. People have already used the code. If you use code Clever Name, it really helps us out, and they'll continue sponsoring us. I think they just care about numbers and they don't care about slurs. But it's. I was trying to think of
how many more orders do we need?
I think like one. I think if you want to be the last one, if you order right now, it's like really, we've reached
live on stream.
Yeah. If you nice. If somebody orders one right now, I think we're done. Or we're done. It's one of the two. But I want one to be safe, I think. It's been hard to keep track and like confirm them all. I've been trying to get people to send screenshots.
When does it need to be
until like the end of September or something like that? Like
really for that goal?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
I know. I'm like we mastered it. We fucking nailed it. So I appreciate
it. Posting it on Instagram.
Did I know.
See it pop so what, up?
There could be people that have used it. You don't even know. But
first one.
Yeah, Martin tested it immediately before we even told anybody. Martin was like, "I'm gonna see if it actually works. Is this real life? Like, it's like a pinch me moment." He's like, "Nah, it works." He sent me a screenshot. I was like, "Good job." So, I was like, "I'm like, this is unreal. We need to figure out something. We can do stuff for our audience too. Like, we could come up with some fucking hilarious stuff." Don't need to tell Manscaped about it. We don't need to send that shit to them. But we need to send them something that's not so Clever Name podcasty, as I would describe it. I don't know.
You need like a solid
faggoty.
Like
that was a perfect use of that. Not so faggoty.
You need like a solid like 14A advertisement.
Yes. That's what I was thinking.
Like like mature but not like
yes. A PG like slightly above PG-13, you can maybe say a cuss word or two.
Like it the 14A where you can drop like shit.
Yeah, innuendo type bullshit. Like that's what we need to do. So I thought of a great idea where I could get Crystal to come and shave my dick and balls while I read the ad. But then I was like, I felt like that'd be a little bit awkward if we did that live. Like I'm like, I'm gonna like pull my dick and balls in, like try and put a blanket over. Don't spit. You're gonna really let Crystal show you up. Look at how good she is at swallowing. Really be a champion. But she just
laughed. Just here in the back.
Ha. But so I was trying to. I was thinking. I could probably pre-record that, but I don't know if that's exactly what they're thinking. And we could just play that mid-show. It'll be funny. I'll try to read their live read while she shaves my dick and balls. Pretty funny. But I don't know if that's enough. I didn't think of that. So I thought of one. It involves Martin. I don't think Martin's going to like it. So we're going to have to debate here. We're going to maybe need to coax Martin into this somehow.
I'm already in. Oh, fuck.
You're already in because it doesn't involve you.
Yeah.
You're not as hairy as I'd like. Martin is the hairiest specimen.
I shave every time before I come here, too. Like, I literally just shaved.
This is maximum hair for me. Like,
You don't get this, eh?
I really don't. It gets very sparse. I do shave it, but it's very sparse. Like, it's sad. But, and I do, I'm like, my chest is fucking nothing. I have, like, 3 or 4 nipple hairs that get aggressive, and that's it. Like, they're like, absurd. Like, they're so obnoxious that you're like, it's so baby smooth. And then there's just aggressive, like, 3 or 4 hairs that I usually just pluck out. But, and then I got, like, a tiny happy trail, but then my pubes get out of hand. Just ridiculous.
That's when you get your lawnscape. Lawnmower 4.0.
Lawnscape. I like
lawnscape.
Blake, do you smell burning curry? Is that an Indian stroke?
Oh, God. Somebody help me. Bell is on fire.
It's very spicy in my brain. You're going like this. You're turning the light bulb. I thought of a pretty good idea. You said you wanted to shave your beard. You already thought of that, and I was like, we might be able to do it. I don't know what the precision of the lawnmower is.
There is a facial,
trimmer?
Facial trimmer from Manscaped.
I just don't think it'll work. How hairy is your chest, Martin?
Can we don't write in it?
That's, I love that. I like where you're going. So, what if we crossbred some of our ideas here, and we made Spictionary Manscaptionary? And we try to draw
into the hair
in Martin's hair the little symbols, and we could guess. Are you checking how hairy you are?
Yeah.
With the amount of hair that you have.
Have to have a fucking.
Is this a doable
drawing? Go.
Perhaps.
Like, the landscape seems workable.
It's up here.
It's not much down here.
Your belly's less? Like, it goes into, like, a V, I'm assuming, right? Like, it goes closer to, like, a happy trail? That's what I would assume. I remember when... I've never actually seen you shirtless, but I remember one time when Jess photoshopped some gay porn, and there was a hairy dude getting butt-fucked, and you were uncomfortable by...
You can pick it up if you want.
It's on Blake's computer. I don't have it. It's like, it's on that computer.
Blake.
It's, but it's, oh, like, it's... It there was like a hairy dude, and then it was Martin photoshopped on him being butt fucked, and then Martin was so uncomfortable with how much it looked like him. He was like, "That just kind of looks like me naked, and it's very uncomfortable." And so I kind of gauged that on the hair. So I figured we could try it small, like simple logos, like little symbols and stuff like that. We could play a little manscaptionary. It might be retarded. It might be a genius idea. I can never tell.
I don't think you can make something small
with a nose hair trimmer.
Oh yeah, the nose hair trimmer though too.
Just like, you just have to hold it on an angle like you're tattooing.
Oh, clipped his nipple.
Yeah, his fucking nipple just.
Just your nipple smooth now. You want to make sure it's warm in here so your nipples aren't pointy. I want them as smooth as possible before we do this. But now I'll avoid the nipples. But I'm saying if we just like. We carve through. We can do simple stuff like the Star of David and maybe some Jewish numbers so we can identify you.
Something big, though.
What do you mean? I wanted to do like maybe one or two rounds.
Write Manscaped in it.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be cool. Oh, I bet you that's been done, though. I bet you that's been done. I just think Pictionary on a person's chest is pretty hilarious.
Yeah.
I think that's fucking funny. And I think we just got the, we do a game where we'll just put Martin's chest zoomed in right on the screen and we'll just try and draw.
It's going to take so long to grow back.
It's so true, and it's going to be all uneven.
You just have to fucking shave it.
Yeah, you'll have to shave down flat.
Because swimming.
You're going to have... like stars and weird, that weird 90s S that everyone used to draw. No, that
Superman or whatever the fuck it
was. Yeah. Superman swastika. And then because it was just the, but
probably
the peace version,
do that, though.
The Indian, the Blake
with
version
the, with the dots.
Yeah, with the little dots in the middle. So it's the Indian peace symbol. It's,
okay.
And then it's a good idea. I was trying to think, and that way, and then you've earned yourself a lawnmower 4.0, and you can shave the rest of your chest down.
That's awesome.
Good idea, right, Ryan? Is that what we're all saying? Are we all cheering for Ryan? Is that was
kind of faggoty?
It's kind of faggoty.
It's kind of faggoty,
but faggoty, but
got it.
Genius. Got to do it. If you guys come up with something better, I'm all ears. All ears.
I'll be thinking.
Thought about it for a week. This is the best I could come up with. Unless we're going to shave Blake down like twink style just so he's smooth. And then maybe like slip and slide him down a fucking thing. I don't know.
I think if we do that, that'll be the rebirth of
Gay. Oh, yeah. Gay Martin's coming back. Yeah. Oh, absolutely. we start our OnlyFans section of CleverNamePodcast.com where me and Martin are parting Blake's butt cheeks to get in there. Shave them down. Yeah, I can see that that's probably going to bring a certain type of audience back to the show, but also might keep our sponsorship for a little while longer. Do you guys want more ball lube or not? It's pretty, honestly, I was the number one bullshitter on Manscaped before.
I remember.
I was like, I'm not buying a fucking crazy expensive ball trimmer and stuff. I used this on my dog. I shaved my dog's dick. Also an idea I thought of because I'm like, Manscaped's really missing an opportunity to have like skin safe dog stuff, like dog trimmers.
Manscaped.
Yeah. Trimmers. So you can, we tried it. I shaved my dog's dick down. It's beautiful. He's probably getting so much pussy now, but
that's why he ran out.
Yeah, he was. Oh, I shaved his dick down. He wanted to show all that he left. It's like, well, I got to show the lady. But then I shaved. The hardest part about shaving down a dog is the paws inside the pads.
Yeah.
I just fucking went, nyam, nyam, nyam. It was smooth, so easy. Didn't nick, didn't do anything. Unbelievably good. Missed opportunity for Manscaped. They need Petscaped. We already came up with the name. Go, do it.
Oh, fuck. Contact them.
I know, right? Yeah. I'll take 2%. 2%.
5.
3.
Fine, we'll start it.
Get 1.
Okay. I will ask for 5, but understand I'll settle for 2. That'd like, if you mad. Talk me down to 2, I'll settle there, but we'll start at 5.
But immediately there, you go 5, and they're like, done.
They probably
then
would.
Would you feel bad? Would you be like, fuck, I should have went for like 10.
Honestly, yes, a little bit.
You have to go in high and then you negotiate.
35%, 115%. I need you to pay me extra for these ideas. But honestly, now that it's out there in the universe, I think it's not copyrighted and they could just do this. Honestly, I don't know why they're not.
Pawscaped.
Pawscaped, great. I still like Petscaped, though. Petscaped, though, because...
That sounds like a TV show, though.
Petscaped? It does sound like some sort of...
Pet cemetery?
No, it sounds like... Sounds like a resort where you would go to hang out with pets or something. Like Petscape. Like it's like a, I don't know, maybe I'm thinking too much. But I think that's a missed opportunity. Like they already have the proprietary stuff. Just change the color of it, put a paw print on it, send it out. Boom. And people.
And charge more.
And yes, absolutely. Charge a pink tax because it's mostly going to be women that are buying it. So just charge a little bit more and do it because it'd be like, we added extra care to make sure your pets are safe. Don't. And then just fucking charge more. Boom. You're welcome, Manscaped.
Well, I think your balls are pretty important. So probably.
That's what I was saying.
Safety. The fuck out
Do you know what else is sick about the lawnmower too? Did you notice a flashlight on it? What?
I didn't know that.
There's a fucking flashlight built into the top of it.
Well, that's so great because when Crystal is shaving my dick and balls and she's going to be under a blanket or so.
The one with like spelunking?
Yeah, I was going to give her one of those headlamps while she was under there.
I think that'd be funnier.
It is kind of funnier. That's what I was thinking. But if it has one.
No, it's fucking awesome because like, yeah, you're in the light, but like then you have light directly on the area where you're working with. So no, you're like,
there's literally a part of your genital area described as where the sun don't shine.
Yeah.
And so no matter what angle you get, unless you're the in jackhammer don't. Position, unless you're getting Amazoned by a big lady, then your butthole is not going to be facing the sun. Your gooch, your fucking where God sewed you up is very difficult to see and like get everything that I don't know how ladies do it. I'm assuming there's some acrobats in there where they can like, they can get all the hairs out there, but
that's why they wax.
Yeah. But it's a missed opportunity is what I'm saying with the pet stuff, because I think that's what I was going to do too. I was going to shave down my dog dick and then make that a thing. Like maybe make like shave down. Just like not just for the human dicks. Not just for, I wish my dog still had balls.
You need to make that a separate commercial and then send them that as well as whatever, because then just be like, okay, here's what you get now. And then you need to watermark the video and everything.
Oh, yeah. Just fucking cover it up. Yeah. Have like this is Jungle Beats on the track.
Yeah. Have a name podcast. It's just the fucking intro playing just in the background. Just the
slurs so they can't get it out.
Yeah, it's just the Overwatch clip.
Oh, yeah. It's a guy who said the N-word. He's got the Guinness Book of World Record for the most N-words. Yeah. Yeah, that's great. But then it goes, it's playing that like carnival music, like, but it's just N-words and slurs, all the ones that we've said on the show, just cut up, just over and over. That's our watermark. Take that out, Manscaped. Yeah, they're not coming back, guys. Fortunately, this is our tip. We've dipped our toe in like a touch of success. Like the same people that sponsor the UFC sent us a package and we are officially sponsored by Manscaped. If you use code CLEVERNAME, you get 20% off. That's a thing. Somebody fucked up in the marketing department, but we're going to exploit that and we'll give them our good. We got our foot in the door. We're like a salesman trying to sell you knives. Yeah. So now we're going to come in and bleed on your carpet is what I think that's how you sell them, because then you also have like cleaning supplies with you and you're like, nothing gets blood out of carpet like our
comes up behind you with the scrub daddy and he's like, look,
genius business model. That's a self-sustaining economy right there. Oh, all right. Look. Let's move on to some of the stuff that I found. You've probably seen this video. Martin probably hasn't made it to iFunny yet, but Blake, you've probably seen it. Have you seen the porta potty fight yet?
No,
I haven't seen the porta potty fight. Okay, so this is some country singer. I'm sure like Dodds or some of the country's fucking people that listen would know who this was. I don't know. I'm going to say Garth Brooks. It's not, but just for the sake of the story, it's Garth Brooks. They're at like a Garth Brooks concert, and I can't explain to you what exactly happened, like how this possibly happened, but this is like a clown car porta potty fight that's so fucking funny to me, and it's going around everywhere right now. So what I like to predict happened is that the chunky lady was in here taking a shit. And, like, she was just in there dropping a heavy deuce.
It looks like she's like, whoa.
She wasn't ready. And I think this, who's getting grappled right here, was her friend that might have been helping out.
Fuck, there's two people there.
Yes, there's two people getting pushed into the porta potty. So now it's a three-person porta potty fight. And this lady looks panicked, but she's like, hold my drink.
Yeah,
hold on a second. Hold on a second. I got to get in on this. Good old-fashioned porta potty fight. So, hold my drink. Three person. The person who was dropping the shit was like, I was just here shitting. And she's like, I don't think she was involved, is my point. This lady... I'm adding a lot of context into this just by watching this, but her reaction to this fight going on, it's like somebody ripped open the door mid-shit, and she's like, what's going on? And she's like, let me out of here, I'm not involved in this. And now, there's a...
And the other...
There's a fourth person comes in,
and they come in aggressive.
There's a person that I can only assume is staff who's trying to break this up, who looks like a Wawa employee, came in and tried to stop it. Very lackluster, just kind of like one-handed, like, please don't porta potty fight here. But honestly, have you ever seen Russian phone booth boxing?
Yeah.
Amazing. But drunk girl porta potty fighting, infinitely better. Dana, please get on this. Slap fighting is bullshit. If you got four ladies in a hot concert porta potty, midday, sitting in the sun, 115 degrees in there. Aww. It is swampy.
And you let Derek Lewis go in first. And then when he comes out, the round begins.
His balls are so hot. They're so hot. And four ladies just come in there and they all just start swinging for the fences. They have there are teams, but nobody can see because of the stench wafting into your eyes. Cell phones are falling into the blue water. Fucking people are getting swirlies. You have no idea what's going on. Everything's on. You're choking people out with a 5-ply toilet paper that's there. That's just thick. It's like cardboard. Yeah. It's that stuff that they
corrugations in it. Like
yeah, cardboard. It's that brown stuff that they use to wash your hand or wipe your hands down. It's just that you're strangling people like you're Epstein in here. But it's wild. So four ladies. But honestly, this chick. I got an eye on her. I like this. She came out of
She comes in with some heat.
She is like, dragging like two people out by her hair out of a porta. She ran in. She was like mid boots and hearts here, and she just fucking came in. It's like the Georgia, sweet Georgia line.
Get the fuck out of here. Look at that shit.
And I believe, correct me if I'm wrong, is this guy holding a piss jug? Like, or is that a bottle? Is that a crazy stein of beer?
That looks like a big fucking thing of beer.
All right, I thought maybe all the porta potties were taken up with chick fights. He's pissing in them. He was like, whatever, piss jug it is. So, yeah, this lady's pulling.
That lady's got one in each hand.
Yeah, and now she just she fixates on one. She goes back for the second.
She's just fucking people up.
She is the third one. The third. She
a fifth takes, one. A fifth she, one came in at the end there.
But the third one that's down there, they all got it. I don't even know whose team this white, the lady in white, I don't know whose team she had. She punched everyone. She fought everyone in the porta potty.
She wants to use the porta potty.
I think she just like, really
I
had this
shit. Fucking shit.
Get the fuck out.
I've been at country music. I've been eating churros and hot dogs all day. I need to shit. She comes in with that energy, and I respect the fuck out of this lady. That's big swinging awesome. Dick of the week. I fucking love that. Let's give her a fucking congratulations.
It's the big swinging American dick of the week.
That lady in white at a concert. She's got her country boots on. I fucking love it.
This is awesome. One in each hand and just fucking, like, she, like, leans into it and pulls them out.
So two people are beating up one person here.
Yep.
I'm trying to follow.
I think she got out of the other porta potty.
Did she?
She just got out. Yeah, look.
Oh my god, she was dropping a deuce next door.
And they were fucking with her. They were she's like, I can't concentrate with this
Do you think she just won her first, like, this is the next, it's like a Mortal Kombat tier list of porta potties? Like, she
it's
just
King
beat
of the Hill style.
If you open up this porta potty that's over here, there's a dead lady in there. She's been fatalitied. And there's shit all over the walls. It's like when Steve-O was in that porta potty in Jackass. It looks like that, but with blood too. And then she ranked up, and now she's going to the final boss with just a four-person fucking brawl inside of a porta potty. I love this. Okay. So
let's see.
Future Mrs. King comes in and drags two out. So wait, this is the part that I'm unclear of.
Boom!
Oh no! She's protecting this lady. She doesn't fight this lady. She gets that lady off. This lady who's just been rocked, she's on Queer Street, gets away, and then she fucks up this second lady. And if she had spurs on her boot, this lady would be dead because she fucking kicked her with the sole of a cowboy boot in the face.
Yeah.
I love that. Yeah. But I can tell you, Martin, Philadelphia. It's in Pennsylvania, baby. Let's fucking go.
Wow.
Yeah, man. So if you wanted to go see the Porta Potty Fighting Championship of the World next time you're in Pennsylvania.
I've been in Philly. It's not nice.
Holy if you, it, did you see this?
Did you see her? This chick walking around with her belt?
I was the one recording. Yeah,
just playing the champ is here over and over again.
Rocky.
Yeah. It's like Stan Marsh from South Park at a baseball game. This chick is fighting anyone that goes into a porta potty, man, woman, or child. And then
no, she goes in. She's like, "Yo, I've just been waiting here so patiently. I need to piss."
It just has to be the one right beside it.
She's just like, "I've been waiting for so long for these ladies to stop fighting in the porta potty."
Lady in the white's like, shit, I dropped my phone.
Yep. She's like, I think I lost something, but bravo, lady. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for really being the woman that, like, that's a woman right there. That's a real
what 20. Is a woman?
What is a woman? Yeah, that's the answer. A lady will fight three people in a porta potty if need be. She was willing to fight the employee.
Yeah, she was like, she don't pushed her
out of
the
way. Yeah, it's like she got out of her way. She realized that wasn't a threat. Then she fucked up the biggest one. That was it was like first day of prison, like, shit.
Immediately,
yeah,
too.
She's like, grab both by the hair. That's amazing.
Throws one to the side, grabs the other one.
Yeah, just boom, boom, boom. She gave up. She was done. Let's move on to the next one. Okay, curb stomped. All right, don't break into my car in the middle of the night. I'll come out in American History X you. Oh, beautiful. Yes. So, yes, I will marry you if you're asking. I just love that level of, like, it's like, she's probably runs her mouth a lot, but you never worried about her. The lady who's willing to get into a porta potty and throw hands, you're never really worried about her going out at night. She'll fuck up a dude. Like, she will. Absolutely, without a doubt. She'll fucking kick him in the face. Probably got great flexibility, too. Like, she uses those high kicks from cheerleading to fucking curb stomp people now.
Like an uppercut, but with her heel.
Love it. Oh. Love it. Beautiful. It's making me respect country music. It's hard to do that, but yeah, she's the one to do it.
Oh, that's so hilarious.
You want to go visit Japan, Blake?
Yep.
Then you know what I got to do beforehand.
I know.
Okay.
Oni-chan!
Listen, it's awesome. Everybody laughs every time, okay? Every and then it's fucking job.
It's like it's so left, it's right. It's just one of those things. So I know that you want to visit Japan. You've been adamant, and I think I found why. I think I've not just because they hang ladies from strings and like piss on them and stuff like we saw. No, this is much more PG than that. A little bit PG. So I don't know if you.
I don't know if I believe you.
PG-13. I'll say okay. We'll go PG-13. This is a bathroom in Japan. It's the sink in Japan.
That's awesome. Wait.
What? He goes back for a second.
What the
fuck? We need one of those. What the fuck? Okay, you got one?
Yeah, but ours just says more trout.
Trout.
Yeah, but it's just got sound drops on the podcast. I pooped in my pumpkin.
Oh, my God.
It's you going, kiss my pussy, Jesus.
You go back up, and it's like, he's fucking your Fruit Loops.
Oh, I went down the wrong pipe. It's just all the fucking shit. Honestly, once we get that Manscaped money, first thing, it's a bidet that says things into your asshole.
It just causes an echo.
It just whispers clips from the podcast into your asshole. It's like, trout.
I would buy.
I'd invest.
Japan is fucked. That's the point. I think
that's
the whole
so smart for like a guy bar, though.
Yeah, right? To be like, oh, you're so big. Like every time you...
Kariko?
That's fucking.
Yeah, what if it called you delicious when you went up to it?
Oh, if it did, if it was, but it would feel artificial. it wouldn't feel right.
That's like a real woman saying it though, live.
But then I wouldn't. If she's paid to do it, I just don't believe it. Like I could obviously.
She has a different saying for a different person. You know?
If she could really sell it to me, or if there was enough blood in my dick already, then I'll just buy it. Because, like, if, like, you stop thinking clearly once there's enough. Like, that's why I think some of those Colombian chicks on the street, really, once you can graze a dick a couple of times, maybe get the blood flowing, then the next one who comes up calls you delicious. You just marry them. Yeah. You just come home with them.
You just get
like
a green card.
I don't know. I don't even know what happened. It was all a blur. There was a group of ladies in a porta potty. They were fighting, and then they rubbed my dick, and now I have a Colombian bride. I don't know. I think I was just watching Clever Name Podcast. All right, so that's all I have from Japan. See, PG-13, right?
Ish.
I think I don't know where that is. I don't exactly know, so we can't find it if we do go there. But I'm assuming most of them have it. Like it's a daycare.
That's a library.
Yeah. Oh my God. So I guess I'll keep with the theme. I did tease that we did have a samurai clip on the show today. Right. So
but no wizard.
No wizard. So with the sweeping gun bans and stuff in Canada, I have never really thought I wanted a katana.
I have one.
But I want one now. I genuinely want a katana. Do you have it like mounted on your wall? Like
no, it's in my closet.
Is it like used for protection? Like if somebody broke into your...
I have throwing knives beside my bed.
That's fucking retarded.
Somebody got me one of my buddies got like military grade throwing knives, and we did like a secret Santa, and I ended up with them. So now they just sit beside my bed.
Have you thrown them?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. But like, if someone broke into your house,
I'd have to stab them. I wouldn't be able to throw it. I'd probably throw it and aim for their head, just so it fucking went punk. But like, and at least like distraction.
Wait, so your instinct, like I have a bat that is like would be my go to. That like Crystal always kept it next to the bed, and it would just out of instinct, I would go like if somebody broke in, I'd grab the bat. Like that would be my first thing. Is your first thing throwing stars?
Knives.
Like oh, they're throwing knives.
Knives.
Stars would be funnier.
That'd be way funnier.
It would be way funnier.
It'd be way easier to stick into people.
Sing. Yeah. Like, you just sleep.
A fucking batarang just comes out from under my pillow.
He sleeps with like a one under his pillow. He's just got it pinched between his finger. He's just sleeping peacefully, and then his girlfriend wakes up and rustles in the middle of the night. Lands right beside her head in the dish.
Like, sorry,
that was just a warning throw. Don't really. You should just piss the bed. Just, you know how I get. But so this clip starts with, I guess somebody got a notification that a group of, we'll call it Fire Alarm Americans, was trying to steal a bunch of bikes from a apartment complex. So this is the outside footage of these people. They're all coming in. And I don't think there's any audio through the whole thing, but so this old man, and then you can probably guess who has the katana by the hairstyle that is being done up like right now. He's literally putting in a man bun, which I think is essential to have if you're using a katana. Like, I don't think I have enough hair to like, if I can't put it up in a man bun, then like, how am I supposed to swing that shit?
Totally make a tiny man bun out of that.
It's just not going to be. It's going to be hard to do in a pinch, though, because you have to put it up before you start swinging. So, like, if a guy breaks in, I'll be like, hold on, I need a scrunchie.
You're like, wait.
Hold on. It's dishonorable to fight before I put my scrunchie in. So, this old man had a security system, and he's showing the young samurai here that somebody is breaking in and stealing a bunch of bikes from downstairs. So, they have to take the elevator. These guys, I think they busted a hole in the gate. But now they've just taken a bunch of bikes from the garage.
Like normal bikes.
Yeah, not motorbikes, but like just regular bikes. And you see him?
He just pulls out a katana.
He pulls out a katana. It comes out with the fucking energy. I love this. Like, where the fuck you at, motherfucker?
Where did he pull it out from?
I don't know. He just has a katana. Dude, if you have like Steve Aoki hair, I assume you have a katana on you.
Dude,
like,
if you see somebody running at you with a katana and you're trying to steal their bike,
you drop the bikes, right?
You drop the fucking bike, right?
These guys are like, uh-oh. And I'm assuming
Holy shit, he's going,
yep,
too.
And they're like, no, they don't get on the bike, which I think is a huge mistake.
That's retarded. Bails. You get on the bike?
I think out of like four or five bikes that they were trying to steal, I think he recovered three. All but one.
Yeah, three or four.
Yeah.
Because there was There's two there.
There's one dropped back. He brought that one back. I think he might. He ended up either getting them all or they only lost one.
He doesn't even have a sheath on him. Or did he?
No, he dropped the sheath in the fucking. That's how intense this was. He dropped the sheath in the fucking elevator. I don't know what happened here.
This old guy just texts his fucking neighbor, "Yo, Weeaboo Jones. There's people stealing bikes downstairs." And he just fucking runs out of
his room. Imagine if he doesn't even know that he has this. He's just like, I always hear him listening to animes. He probably has a katana. Like, honestly, like, if somebody knocked on your door and it's just like, there's people stealing downstairs, you would have throwing knives.
That's facts.
And if they would, their assumption would have been right. There would, like, oh, he's a weeb. He probably has some sort of exotic knife or something that he could take out these that they won't be expecting to come down and be like, yeah, he does. In fact, he has like a whole wall. It's like an arsenal of
actually,
old.
I have quite a few knives.
Just like, it's just like an Imperial Japan soldier's room for some reason. You're like, why? I don't understand.
There's just a suit of armor in the fucking corner.
Dude, how funny is it? You know, like, Batman has that fucking, that, like, little switch to go into the Batcave? Like, Blake has, like, some, like, big titty weeb pillow or something like that. Or, like a big titty mouse pad, but you flip one of the titties up and it's got a button. You press the button, and then all of a sudden, it flips around a wall. And then there's just, like, nunchucks, like every stereotypical like Japanese weapon that you could have is just on a little board, but he's like, I'm ready. I've been waiting for this moment that people steal shit from me.
I just fucking blew up my Naruto headband that Martin got me. It is time.
That is the gayest. And you run with your fucking arms out like a dork.
Just fucking
yeah, well, that's kind of Japanesey. I'm pretty sure this wasn't Japan, judging by the amount of fire alarm Americans that were there. But
I think it's one of the Mexicos.
Do you think this is one of the Mexicos?
Yeah, look at how they spell elevator.
Oh. Elevador.
Did they spell elevador wrong?
Elevador.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't even notice. Oh yeah, elevador social. Maybe it's just a person.
And I can't see a website.
Huh?
It might just be a website. Like, is Elevador Social? Like, oh, like, yeah. Elevator cam footage shit.
Oh, it's like Live League for elevator footage. Yeah, it's mostly people just shitting and pissing in elevators when they get stuck in it. That's most of the. Speaking of that, I actually have a video of that. Oh, I'm pretty sure I do. But we don't have to go down that rabbit hole just yet. I did have another primordial video if you wanted to see it.
Always.
Judging by what I can see, I don't know. I want to. I'm like, we're just gonna be playing fake or real here, basically. Like, oh, is this a reality, or is this some sort of weird, cruel joke? But,
we're good.
I don't know what this is. I don't know what this is.
Oh,
what?
That's fake.
It has to be, right?
Yeah. Yeah, you can tell. It looks like there's like,
what? Yeah. Is she shitting liquid? What is it?
It's just something. Is that just something stuck in her ass?
I think there's a big ass dildo stuck in her ass.
That's horrible. Thank
does
you.
It go back in? Like, if you pour salt on it, does it go back inside like a slug?
Dude, do you think it's actually your fucking butthole?
No.
I don't think your butthole's that wide. Like your
rectum.
Yeah, maybe it is. Taking some monster shits. Like, but so you think this is a thing that's put in?
Yeah, for sure.
I think it's either a dildo that was put in or somehow she shit her insides out.
No,
I've seen a lot of insides be shit out and it's never been that big. This chick's got a fat colon. If that's
dead.
I don't know, but yeah, it's not that horrifying. It wasn't that horrifying. But
yikes.
Well, if it's real, actually, that's one of the most horrifying things I've ever seen.
That was actually her.
But I think we all are just like huffing copium right now, and we're just going like,
"Nope,
yeah, no, it's not real. It's not real. No."
That's what I do every time I leave this podcast. It wasn't real.
It was all a dream. It was all a dream.
You guys are finally learning.
You guys are. That's what Martin does every week.
He's just rocking back and forth at home.
So, Blake, I don't think you were here for the trout. You don't remember the trout.
I was not
trout.
Here for trout.
You weren't
trout,
here for trout. The trout. So I'm gonna have to give
part
you like
two?
No. I'm gonna just, well, sort of. I'm gonna have to give you a little update, just like just so you can just be aware. So a couple of weeks ago, Primordial sent us this video.
That's how you catch a trout. Yeah. Ooh, that trout's wiggling.
What do you got here?
The trout's wiggling.
Where's the trout?
What the fuck? Oh.
He wants to wriggle, right?
Yeah, it's like the best concert Green Day's ever performed at. It's actually live. Like, they're right over there. There's fireworks going off. It's crazy.
Well, I think you see some nymphs in there. I think you see a nymph in there.
What language is this?
I'm pretty sure it's Australian.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's drunk Australian. But there's the best part is coming up.
I think I'll strike that asshole, but I'll damage that earlier. Can I go deep with the trout?
Deeper with the trout.
You don't mind?
Send it.
Send it.
Send it.
Yeah, she said. He says, "Can I go deep with the trout?" And she says, "Send it," which is fucking hilarious. It's one of the funniest, the funniest interaction that's ever happened with a trout and a pussy. Just fucking send it.
Fucking send it, bud. What are you fucking waiting for?
You send that right up there until it's hitting Utes, bud.
Don't be a fucking hoser. Give me more trout.
I want him to tickle the fucking ovaries, buddy. I want him to be breathing pussy juice.
Just call when you've had enough trout. That'd be enough, mate. You want more trout? Take it.
More trout.
That's enough trout.
And then he goes, "That's enough trout, isn't it?" So, I don't know if you guys... I found a video for you guys, which I am entitling Trout Simulator. Okay. So, it's a lot tamer than you think, but I just wanted, if you wanted to feel like that trout.
Oh, what the fuck?
Here you go.
What the fuck do you mean?
Oh, guys, I don't like the look of this.
Oh, dang. Oh, trout. Well, trout.
I think it's honestly it because of all the sticks or something of it. Yeah. I'm going to go back there just to make sure.
Oh, yeah. Trout Simulator. Trout in it.
Full send it. Just send it.
We're sending it.
Is this just like spelunking and nasty?
It's so deep and cold over here.
That's exactly what the fish was saying. It's so deep and cold in here.
Let me put the GoPro underwater and see what I can see.
That's the same stuff.
It's exactly what the fish was seeing.
Now
it's just murky.
Not only hears.
Yeah, there's just, oh, there's no pro.
Dude, you have to dub it over.
Oh, just as a combination video. More trout, isn't it?
Gargle.
Oh, it's so cold. So, yeah, I call that video Trout Simulator. If you wanted to feel what it perfect, right? When I saw that video, I was like, oh my God, is that a vagina? Is this the cave of vagina? It's like, that looks like that disgusting old Australian lady's pussy. It's like, oh, now I know what it feels like to be a trout.
Why would you stick a trout up your pussy? Like, what is...
Clout? Trout clout?
Trout clout?
Trout clout.
Oh my God, hashtag trout clout. Start a new Twitter trend. Sorry, start a new X trend.
Yeah, sorry. Yeah. If you want to see my trout porn, you got to hit me up on X. Or X hamster. Just keep typing.
X trout.
It's very confusing now when you type X into your browser. You're either going to go to Twitter or a porn site. Like, that's what's going to be there. You realize that when you type in... It's going to be like X hamster, X video, XXX something. Like, it's going to be all porn stuff.
God
damn it, Elon Musk. He's going to get some, like, teachers and stuff in trouble that are, like, displaying stuff. And they'll be like, okay, well, let me go to Twitter. X hamster. Fucking.
That's why you did it.
I think so. I think he just loves porn. Yeah, that's what it is. So that's why he bought Twitter, because it's mostly porn. So I found this video. I guess we can head over to Russia. Do you want to check out what's going on in Russia?
Comrade.
Yeah, we got to play the comrade.
Party never stops. 5 stars from the cops. Rushing through the city like it's Vice City, suka,
blyat. it's a great fucking video. So I found this video. that is, first off, I can't explain to you what's going on here other than mental illness, I guess. So this is supposed to be a, it's got to be fake. This is as fake as the prolapse, but it's a trans Russian influencer, I guess, who's trying.
You're alive there?
I know. She's trying to not be, but she's trying to hang herself.
Oh no.
But she's not like it. No, she's not trying to hang herself like at all, because you can't hang yourself from a doorknob. Like, it's just not going to work. Like, you're going to hit ground before, like, yeah. So the biggest cry for attention, you can understand why the trans suicide rate is so high and like the follow through is just there, because it's more theatrics. It's like all the makeup and the having a penis when you're a woman. It's all like, oh, look at me. That's what's going on here. So. So you know when I go to kill myself, I set up my phone and you can see me click the start button and then start to cry, because I've been thinking about this for a long time and I'm like, hold on, let me get this for the TikTok. Click. I'm going to kill myself. So, yeah, you know it's probably real. And then she takes like
a paper?
Yeah, maybe like a Polly Pocket belt. Like, and honestly, that's what you would say to get them out of this. Because if you act all like, if you went like, oh my god, no, don't do that, you have so much to live for, blah, 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 blah. That's just going to get them the attention that they wanted. If you literally went like, what the fuck is wrong with you, you dumb fuck? Yeah. Like, this looks stupid. You look dumb.
I gotta take a piss, get out of my way.
Yeah, literally. And fight them like the girls in the porta potty. You get, you get that lady from the Garth Brooks concert to come in here and just fucking boot fuck this lady right in the mouth while she's still attached to the doorknob. Like,
look at how politically correct you are. You're saying she and everything.
I know. Aw, go me. Congratulations. We did it. We did it. I'm woke now. I think I'm woke now. So now if they can boot fuck this thing into not wanting to kill herself, we'd be in a better spot. Very progressive of me.
Oh my god.
So there's more from Russia. Honestly, I don't know what Ukraine is doing, but it seems like the water's on fire in Russia. Nice. But they're making the best of it, honestly. I would do this. Looks like he just does a warm shower. This is like, I don't know how this is happening.
Probably hot.
It's a good catch. See what you did there? Probably. I would assume the water is very warm at the very least.
Yeah.
But
what is it? Just oil and water?
I don't know exactly what they're doing. Yeah, it's probably a prolapsed anus.
This, like, is the gay super soldiers that they're trying to make.
Yes.
This is how they're making gay super soldiers.
That's exactly how they do it. But I don't know. I think they're just like pumping
vodkas in that fucking water.
That must be it.
Exactly. That's the fucking local potatery.
The same percentage of the adrazine or whatever that makes the frogs gay in our water is how much vodka is in theirs. It just balances it out.
Russia, and you're like, oh, aqua vino, what is that? And you taste it and you're like, oh,
I am shit faced. You're like, I keep brushing my teeth and then I'm fucked. Like, why is this happening? Yeah, but honestly, this seems like a hot spring. Like, you know, they have those in like Iceland or whatever. Like, this is a Russian hot spring. Like, it's just vodka water lit on fire and then a drunk guy named Sergey underneath it. You know, his name's Sergey. I don't know that his name is Sergey, but his name is Sergey. Yeah, and then the piece de resistance of Russia is, I don't exactly know what this what's happened, but this is just titled The Ending of Summer in Russia. So it looks like a fat lady and some dude fighting over a paddleboard thing. This might be just a comrade stream. So I feel like, because he loves going, paddleboarding seems to be big in Russia. So this guy's got a paddleboard. And then there's a large guy, and now it's a two-on-one with a paddleboard. Two paddleboard. Oh, that's a broom and a paddleboard. His lady broke the broom off this guy's back.
I thought she threw it at him.
No, she snapped it on his back. Look, watch. snap.
Oh yeah,
the piece goes flying, and he was like, what the fuck was that? He looked back, was like, all right, lady, hold on, I still gotta fuck up your husband first. There's a kid
disarmed.
Yeah, there's a kid crying somewhere in the distance. He's a Russian man. Is you know what? That is Russian feminism right there. Only giving body shots to women. Yeah. Honestly, did you see the restraint that he had there? He thought about clobbering her in the head.
He need her.
Look, and then a good body shot there. Yeah, and, but immediately when he switches to the man, all headshots. All
he knees her in the head though.
Yeah. No. Yeah. He hit her in the gut.
No, no, it looked like it hit her in the head.
No, that's a. No, that's a tit. No. That was a tit. Was a tit one. It was a tit. Body shot, headshot. That is what we call Russian feminism. Thank you. He is just as woke as me for calling that thing a she. Thank you. Thank you, Russia.
But what we call gender equality.
It's gender equality. So it continues fighting. The woman, I think, had her fill. She seems to have backed off.
Nope.
Yeah, I think she swings. She's trying to get her. Oh, yeah, right. She's repeating something in Huinyo, something, but she in the meantime, Russian Dan Blazarian knocked the fuck out of the husband. And I don't know what this head-to-head thing, I see it, it's like Eastern European. Martin, if you were in a fight, is your instinct to just go head-to-head with them?
Obviously.
I see it in so many Polish videos. It's like Eastern European. It's like soccer hooligan shit. Yeah, they go head-to-head, and usually the first punch is thrown by a headbutt. Like, a lot of the time in Eastern European fights, they just, like, push into each other's foreheads, and
like
then they
fucking
go,
goats? Whop!
Yeah, exactly. And then they start throwing hands.
We got strong skulls.
Strong skulls, yeah. Probably all the vodka in the water.
But, oh, so, slaps him.
Yeah.
Oh, off a car. Slaps him again.
It's like, do you really want some to the wife?
This guy's just like, dude, stop coming at me.
Stop it. And the wife finally changed teams. She was literally like, you're losing in Battlefield, and you're like, all right, changing teams.
Yeah.
Like, she switched sides and was like, we fought 2-on-1, I'm out, and you're clearly going to lose. Yeah. Like, we've already lost this fight, so please stop. So she's now trying to contain what I can assume is her husband.
He's fucking looking for which one hit him.
Yeah. He's lost.
He's like, which one of you three hit me?
And then,
oh,
he snuck around while she was on her phone.
Fucking spit but, on him.
Yeah, he spit and actually landed a punch there. That's hard to see. You can kind of see him swing in there. Yeah. I've watched it multiple times. He does land some sort of a punch that seems to get Dan Blazarian pretty pissed here. And the palm strikes that this dude has are insane. And I think Russia was one of the first people to figure out that power slap thing is almost more effective than a punch. Because, like, you can keep doing that all day. You can patty cake this motherfucker's face over and over again, and it's just going
to
sting your hand.
Clobbering them. And
they're yeah, they're like, getting... If you hit them on the ear, they're fucking... Your brain's fucked. If you just keep hitting them on the side, their face will swell up. Have you seen some of those dudes in the, like, the slap fighting? Their cheeks swell up. They have fucking teeth problems.
Because they have, like, gauze and shit, too, just to protect, like, their teeth.
And your hand's fine. If you punched them 3 times in the skull, you're probably going to break some, like, metacarpals and shit in your knuckle. Like, it's a better idea just to open hand or even just, like, palm strike. Just keep doing that. They figure that out, and now it's just street fighting. And it's so embarrassing to watch because it looks like you're just bitching a little kid. You're just like, fuck you. like, oh, damn, that was badass. But yeah, that's Russia. Russia creates the metas for fighting. Like the ladies at the concert. Russian phone booth fighting. It started there. You bring it to the country music festival porta potties. America's very, it's like the American Office. Sure, the British one was pretty funny, but you know what? The American one was more successful, and I think porta potty fighting will be more successful than Russian phone booth fighting. So, pretty solid. Now, you want to see the most based horse in the history of mankind? Yeah. So, I found this horse, and it's walking down the street. I don't exactly know where it is, but it comes to... stop for some reason.
It's in the UK for sure.
Probably. Or yeah, it's definitely the UK. We'll assume that. But Didn't know there was such based wildlife there or animals there. Nope. Because
it tells me it. Tell me it shits on the fucking thing.
Nope, but they refuse to touch the gay crosswalk.
Yeah, they're like, we're not going on that.
This one accidentally touches it and goes, no. It even, the prance turned effeminate. It turned into a dressage horse, and it was like, ew, boys, let me get off this. And then it went up. Oh I can't believe they're walking. Wait. Wait a minute. What That's the gay. Fuck is this faggoty shit? And they're like, nope. I learned this in training. If I touch that, I'll be a homo. No. That is piss off. And then they just continue on. Based horse. I love you, horse. Thank you. Thank you for really perpetuating it. It sometimes takes like animals to show us the way that we should be. In society. Sometimes you gotta go back. You gotta go all the way back to horses. When we evolved from horses. This is the base society that I want to live in, where you refuse to do that. Where you take the big stairs and refuse to take the gay stairs.
Dude, it's like when our city got the crosswalk downtown and people just did burnouts on it all day until it was gone.
Badass.
And they just had to keep coming back and painting it. I was like, every time they come back and waste the money on this, somebody comes by and fucks it up again.
Mm-hmm. It's like almost like a game now. You've created a monster, and nobody wants to see Marshall no more. Sorry. Oh my God. Yeah, I apologize heavily. So, you know what a toilet sexual is?
Nope.
All right. So I'm going to read you the translation so you can understand this video, because this is, I think, Russian as well. I believe this is Russian. Could be Ukrainian, because it does say something about Ukraine at the end. So I will read you verbatim what this lady is about to say to us. This toilet was stolen by my dad in Bucha. After which he died in Artemovsk. It was told that Alexander Zakarinchenko, Prime Minister of Donetsk, shat here, and that arouses me immensely. I am a Russian slut, Slava Ukraine. All right, so now I think you can kind of see where this is going.
Украл мой отец из Бучи. После он умер в Артемовске. Говорят, что в него срал сам Олег Рачко. И меня это очень сильно возбуждает.
What does that mean? What?
Shit. They shit here.
Martin goes, ha, she said shit.
That's in Polish too.
I love it. It's hilarious.
Ведь я русская шлюха. Слава Украине.
Oh. Did you almost throw up? You didn't see this coming?
I don't.
Wait, she goes back for seconds.
But she's just looking. Why is she doing this?
I know, right? Now the final question that we have to ask is,
yes.
Would you? Yeah. I know, right? We're such terrible people. I still would. Like, even after this part where she swirlies herself in the shit water.
Oh.
Yes.
I know, yes, and that makes you an honest person, but like, I would make her dry her hair first. I wouldn't want that. I don't want the Prime Minister's shit water on me. And like, is she gonna have to like do some foreplay with the toilet to get aroused? She's like, I don't get wet unless I bidet with the toilet water. I splash a little on my puss.
Licking the toilet seat got me, like...
Really?
Did you hear that?
So much worse than that.
Really? That's what gets you?
I don't know. Apparently.
that's what... Hold on. Maybe we can make it better for you. I'm sure we can make it improved here.
Looks pretty clean.
Well, someone shat there. I don't care. I don't care if it's in the Home Depot lobby. I don't want to, like it hasn't been installed anywhere. I don't want to lick it. And this, the toilet was stolen? Who steals a toilet? It's like,
the Prime Minister
shat in here. He probably fucking shaved his pubes in here.
Steal Trudeau's toilet?
Okay, that's cool. Would you lick it? If I can successfully steal it, would you lick it?
I'd paint it black.
I see a red toilet and a
that's a kind of, those were both quality. I love that. That might have been one of your best jokes. That deserved way more. I should have laughed hysterically at that. That was great. Good job. Moving on. We're not getting any better than that. We've gotten all we can get out of the toilet sexual lady. So I guess we'll just wrap up with this week in woke, unless you want to see a lady poop in an elevator. I said I had that, but it's just picture a lady and then she poops in an elevator.
In my elevator.
All right.
All right, now I gotta fucking see the goddamn elevator.
Blake has to jump over it, though.
Okay, there is. So.
Oh my god, I can't hold it. I shouldn't have had that cheesy quesadilla.
You're gonna need to delay. She does hang on for a bit. So.
Light a cigarette.
She's got like a cigarillo and like or like a Colt, like she's holding it, but she's got the leg crossed like it's already turtle. She's using like physics to keep it in, like she's using like a fulcrum method to like hold her butt cheeks with extra force.
She's just like, shouldn't have kept eating that salsa. My god,
there is something about getting closer to the toilet that makes it like an inevitability that you're gonna shit. Like sometimes I'll have to shit the entire way home. I was stuck in traffic for an hour and a half last night. I had to shit probably 45 minutes in.
Oh my god, you had to come back here in cottage country traffic.
Fuck. And they shut down the highway for an accident.
Yep.
Yeah, it was a fucking nightmare. They diverted everybody onto a side road with stop signs. It was awful, but I had to shit during it. But once you get to the finish line where you're like, you can almost see your home.
And it starts creeping out of you.
It's like it's fighting its way like it's a lady in a porta potty. No. I'm going to keep going back to the porta potty well. It's fighting to get out. And you're like, so when you're in the elevator and you can almost smell home turf and you're like, your body releases. Yeah, oh my god. Hold on.
Oh,
1,
no.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 floors that there could be.
That's at least a minute.
There's a potential of her going up 16 floors.
Oh, good.
And you know it's already at critical mass if your legs are crisscross applesauce just standing there. Like, she's X gonna give it to you with her with her feet. And she's wearing sandals and shorts. The worst possible combination you could have if you're gonna shit your pants. Like, there's nothing worse. If you had shoes, at least if you shit your shorts and it comes down, at least it's not gonna be all in your socks and stuff. Like, it's like, if she's got Birkenstocks, and I'm assuming, not a very solid shit. Because if you're fighting this hard, it's not just gonna be like a log. Yeah, logs are easier to hold.
She's oh my god, I remember that time with the apple juice. It's just like that.
Oh, if she coughs right now, it's going to be a problem. That might be it. She takes a drag of her cigarillo and it goes down wrong. It goes, oh no. And it just starts leaking. Like it starts and doesn't stop. But we'll continue. So she's fighting for her life. She's fighting her inner demons. Every bad decision that brought her to this moment is running through her head. She's like
running down her leg.
Yep. She's like, I just didn't want to shit. And she gives up. She gave up. Okay. She gave up, and she's like, here it goes.
My God.
At this moment, I thought she was peeing, because I thought I saw, I see her, do a little, flick on her foot. Oh, wow, that's metal as fuck. Yeah. But now you can see, that was a perfect timing, right when we saw the shit. You can see, no wipe.
Is it bloody?
I don't know. It's not healthy. I'll tell you that if we brought out the poop chart, it would be in the very unhealthy range.
Like chili.
It does. Oh. It looks like she ordered a large Wendy's chili, and that's it. That's all and it made it all the way through. It's probably what Blake's shit's going to look like after he ate all that hot sauce later.
Dude, it actually wasn't that bad.
Do you have any elevators?
Yeah, I eat spicy shit all the time.
I get that. But do you have any elevators to go in today?
I could find some.
So, she's... Now, if you're this lady who you hit the point where you had to shit in the elevator and you're stuck, you're just praying to God that when this elevator door opens, nobody is there. Yeah.
What I would do is I'd see whatever floor I'm at. Like, they're at floor five.
I'd hit six or seven.
You
I'd
just
hit
get off and
immediately get off
and try a different elevator stairs. I don't know. I don't know if she's fully evacuated. I don't know if you want to start doing stairs when you have diarrhea. But yeah, so she's at five. This elevator seems to be dangerously slow because they are still at five.
That's why I said the cross legs.
Okay, and then she got there. And by the grace of God, nobody is standing there waiting to get on the elevator because goddammit, if Comrade was doing a live stream there and just opened up the door, like, suka, blyat, it's not like shit in here.
She made it home.
Almost. Literally right there. Right there. So close. And now you have a shitty butthole in your SpongeBob shorts or whatever the fuck you were wearing. And
would you clean it? Like, would you come back and clean it?
No, absolutely not. No, because it gives me a chance of being caught.
Yeah.
That admits
but
guilt.
You already caught you on camera.
Yeah, but to the ones.
But if you clean it up, it lessens.
Maybe they didn't get a clean shot of my face, though.
I don't know if you guys remember this. We saw a similar elevator video in Russia where a couple got into a fight, like a fist fight, and they bled everywhere. There was blood. Like, it looked like The Shining.
No, I don't remember blood.
What? No, yeah,
it's
no.
Different than shit, though.
It is. But then the couple came back together after they were fist fighting each other and cleaned the blood together.
I wasn't here for that one.
That was
no
so
way.
Funny. Yeah, it was hilarious. They were full of, like, I might even have been a knife involved, but there was so much blood everywhere.
If you don't, like, elevator, I would feel bad. Like, I would go back and clean it. That was me.
That's the argument. After you settled the fist fight argument, now you're like, we can't just leave that blood there.
Well, you have to think ahead, too, like, because you know, someone's gonna have to clean that.
You have hepatitis.
They're gonna watch the camera and see who it is. They're gonna see where you got off. They're gonna send you a fucking bill to clean that. So if you go back and clean it yourself.
That's true. They do know where you live, and like they can just upcharge your rent. Yeah. And it's communism there, so they just dock your pay.
Yeah,
yeah. You're probably living in the factory that you work at, so they just don't pay you for the next couple of days to clean up the shit.
So if you clean it yourself, it's less.
Yeah, but then you have to go back and. It's just a whole thing.
It's your own shit, though. It's not like...
Anyway. All right. Let's do This Week in Woke, and then we'll wrap it up. Sound good?
Bingo.
Oh, yeah. We'll do bingo. Even though you've already won.
We didn't do bingo last week.
Yeah, we didn't. Because he's the one that reminds us, because he's the champ.
Yeah.
Champ is here.
I played bingo last
week. Did you play? You played it by yourself? Yeah. Aw, cute. Anyway.
Five.
Let's do This Week in Woke, a quick one, and then we'll do some bingo.
Okay, boomers. Let's try it together. If someone goes machine and call her die,
he's thrashing headbang.
If someone goes machine and call her die, doesn't mean that you die.
I roll my eyes back, flip my eyelids like that. That's what we gotta do when we do it. Okay. You gotta do shit like that before we. Okay. Do you guys remember Kayla Lemieux?
No.
Does her name ring a bell?
Pokemon?
No, it does sound like a Pokemon. And
you use lightning bolt.
This could be a Pokemon. Now does this picture ring a bell?
Oh yes, I know exactly what this is.
Yeah,
I
saw this. So this is the big titty woodshop teacher from Oakville, I think.
Yep.
Like we could go and visit her.
Pretty close. It is Oakville.
Yeah, I know. Like, can we get a live interview? Are they speaking out? Are they even a real person? Like, can we just go and wait outside and do an interview? Like, hey, what's up? So you've probably seen on social media, it's gone around. She was on paid suspension. She, it, they, I don't know what they want to call. But this thing was on suspension for and getting paid and just staying home for last year. But the school season.
Yeah.
Yeah, school season started. They've lifted that. And this thing's allowed back. And they showed up like this.
Jeez.
So, do you remember a long time ago, I found an obscure Reddit post claiming to be from a person who knows this person personally.
Yeah, and got in trouble for toxic masculinity.
Yes, and they just went, so far left, they turned right. Like, they were like, oh, well, if I can't just say, like, oh, pro-Trump stuff or something like that, if I can't wear my MAGA hat, I wonder if I can wear giant comical titties. And it's like, that's a hilarious contrast. If that's the case, this guy's the greatest fucking meme lord in the history of mankind. But if it's not, then there's some sort of delusion going here and this person's teaching our kids. If it's the first one, they should absolutely be teaching our kids because that's hilarious. And like, this is like meme warfare. It's amazing.
Yeah, he's just like, this is how you get around it without actually getting in trouble. He's like, I got paid to leave.
for a year.
I got paid. If I wore a MAGA hat and refused to take it off, I would have been fired or on unpaid suspension until I agreed to take it off. If I wear comically large titties where you can see not only the nipple, you can see the areola bumps around the nipple. You can make out the diameter of the titty, of the nipple and everything. It's wild. So I can like read the braille on your titties over there. And that's completely allowed. That's, we don't want to discriminate against this brave, beautiful individual that just looks like Tim Dillon. Like, it's just like fat Tim Dillon. It's a perfect reference. I get that you don't get it because he's just a fat podcaster who makes billions of dollars. Nobody knows who he is. He has the greatest life ever because Tim Dillon, just understand that, looks exactly like this, is a gay guy that nobody thinks is gay because he sounds just like a regular straight conservative dude.
Yeah.
And he looks like this and makes probably $20,000 a month on Patreon plus a bunch of other stuff. Just saying nothing. Just not even the amount of effort that we put in here. He just yells about stuff all the time. And it's just fun to watch for some reason. And you could walk down the street and barely anyone's going to know who he is. It's wild. None of you know who Tim Dillon is. Artie would. Artie got that joke. Respect, Artie, for laughing at that.
He let the heat inside.
Are you cold? Are you actually cold? Well, that's good. I'm proud of that because I was worried you guys were going to be sweating your balls off. I can open the door. Because I can, the second I open the door, it's like the fucking desert.
Feel it?
Yes. It's pretty bad. But I think the sun's gone down, so it's probably not that bad anymore. But all right, so that teacher's back at school. I don't know if we want to take a trip down to Oakville, maybe on your way to PEI, stop there.
Yeah.
Let's just go, maybe get an interview. See if this guy's based as fuck. Like maybe we get another co-host.
Just walk up and he goes, more trout.
He's a fan of the show.
You win.
just knuckles you up and gives you a trout. that's great. All right. So let's pull up bingo. If you don't know, if you go to clevernamepodcast.com, there's a little bingo icon right there. You click on the bingo thing.
I got an Artie card, man.
Haha. Get fucked. Well, that's the.
Yeah, I got two Arties.
Get luck of the draw. So you pull up, you click the little bingo icon. It'll give you a random bingo list of nine different things that happen on the show very regularly. Mine's
awful.
Ryan gets worked up. I get it. I'm always worked up.
Yep.
But Ryan works up about something small. That's always happened.
Yep.
Shit is guaranteed. Let's fucking go. Artie is drunk.
Probably.
Now, yes, thank you.
Depends where he is.
He is at work.
Maybe.
I think it's almost guaranteed that he's drunk.
But I think he wants to keep this job.
I'm going to go out on a limb that hey, even Artie, if he hasn't drunk? Been drinking. Hey, Artie, are you drunk? Are you here right now? I told him to come into the chat and tell me a bad joke, but I don't know if he did. I'm going to go ahead and give that a preemptive yes.
It's a half.
I don't know if I can half check it, but nudity.
Always.
Was there nudity?
Yes. The chick with the ass.
Yeah, with the ass thing.
That maggot come out of her ass.
Nudity. Gay stuff.
Yes.
What was gay?
Everything.
Faggoty. Well, it's
not gay.
Was there any like actual gay stuff?
I don't think so. Gay stuff. Are we evolving?
Wow. Well, you mentioned gay stuff though.
Did we?
Yeah, when did we mention?
You getting butt fucked. Yeah. Thank you. You saved my card. Thank you. Blake says, oh my God, you had to have.
Had to have.
You had to. When the lady licked the toilet or something. Dad's OnlyFans. Nope. Not coming up. Nope. Damn. Wrist lump came up. Artie bombed.
Blake's OnlyFans, though.
We did?
My OnlyFans?
Yeah, are we
shaving? Oh, when I shave your butthole.
Yeah.
It's fun to go back to see what we just talked about. Yeah. Close. Blake's OnlyFans, a new thing. Artie's bombs. As much as he didn't, he probably did. But like still,
so it's pretty big bomb.
I'm going to give him a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.5. I'll give myself, or sorry, 5.5. Give myself 5.5 because the gay stuff was like iffy. We're all kind of gay. We're all kind of faggoty. But all right, so what do you got?
Who
cares? I don't care. Both say it at the same time over top of each other and don't stop. Martin, go ahead.
Racism.
Are we racist?
Oh, shut the fuck up. Do you not remember when Crystal came in here and told you that she didn't...
watermelon but not chicken?
and that looked was... you in your soul. Like, didn't even address any of us. Like, we would also like some chicken and watermelon. She looked at you. You're not even
and it
black.
Took me like a, it took me like a like couple seconds, too. I was like, oh.
I know, because you're like, no one would be that. She just ran in with a watermelon. She just came in with a watermelon. No.
Yeah.
No, order chicken.
Okay, it's
Brown. Sprite.
Sprite. Get some Sprite too. 50 years of hip hop.
Oh my god.
So Blake, do you think there was some racism?
Okay.
Okay, racism. Yeah, Martin, I think you get that one. Good job. Oh, racism.
Shit.
Shit.
Shit, yep, guaranteed. She brought it.
Chicken fries. Yeah. Chicken fries.
What else we got?
Okay, you want some chicken fries and watermelon?
We need a smoke detector.
Dude, can you unplug the battery? Can you, like, decharge the battery from the smoke detector? We're trying to hit all the metas. Okay.
Okay, technical difficulties. I think we're good this week.
I honestly think there wasn't any.
Was there any at the beginning?
I think they're late, though. But.
No, we didn't. No, we didn't. I started right on time.
Yeah.
Oh, that's weird. Like, that's a technical difficulty. That is odd. But, excuse me. Yeah, no, I think I'm going to go out on a limb and say we nailed it this week.
Nice. Oh, good
job. Good job. All
right, Artie randomly brings out a prop. Did you do that at work, Artie?
I'm going to guess he did. He just has a rubber chicken. Chicken. Yeah, he's just in his back pocket. I'm like, Artie. Fuck Artie. He's fucking a Mexican carrot top. Weird.
I know. Dog interruption. Always.
Oh, yeah. Poncho came in. Yep.
Artie bombs.
Yes, but probably. No. We can't give it to you. We can't confirm it.
Wrist lump.
Wrist lump.
Wrist lump.
Oh, I thought you said Islam. Islam. I just like shout out to Islam. Shout out Sharia law.
Okay. Artie is drunk. Okay.
Yeah, that's. I'll give you that one.
And a failed joke.
Yeah, probably.
You had one.
What did? What was it?
I don't know. I blank everything.
Did you boo? Did you boo me? I don't remember it.
Yourself.
Yeah, I can see that happen.
It was a small one.
It was small, but there. I'm sure it was there.
I got six.
Six. Good job. You beat me. Good job. Kay. Proud of you. Blake?
The white man marches on.
We didn't. I think I said white power a couple times.
You did. You definitely did.
There was opportunity, but I didn't do it.
Failed joke.
Yep.
Artie brings out a prop.
Yep.
We'll just say yes because he probably has a rubber chicken on him.
Someone says something dumb.
Yep.
Drugs are done.
Yep.
Maybe. Artie is drunk.
No, we smoked dabs before the show. We did. Yeah, we did. Before the show. No, but that's a pre-show. Still counts.
Hitting his fucking.
I was hitting my vape
too.
Pen. Fucking that salsa that Blake was eating is probably some sort of drug. So it could probably make some people hallucinate.
Artie is drunk.
Yep.
Yep.
Gay stuff.
Yep.
Kind of. Half. I'll give you half because I don't remember the specific gay stuff. Unless we're considering me shaving your chest as gay stuff.
I was getting.
Oh wait, no. Yeah. How is yeah? Me shaving your butthole is pretty gay.
That's pretty gay.
All right, I'm gonna count it. I'm going. I'm up in mine to 6 points. Then let's go.
Yep. Woo. I say, oh my god.
Yep.
And Ryan says something dumb.
Damn, did you just nail the whole card?
If
Artie was here, you would have had it. God damn.
No white man marches on.
No white man. Oh, man. Should have pressed me. Should have just said some real stuff that made me feel patriotic to my people.
You even talked about American History X, too, and never hit the button.
So many opportunities.
I mean, you can play that as an outro.
I always have it.
The white man marches on!
Let's fucking go! We did it! All right, thanks everybody. If you want to go check out our website, if you listen this far and you're on iTunes and wherever, we're on Rumble. A lot of people are following us on Rumble for some reason.
Yeah.
I don't even know how. I just post the episodes on there. I don't really do anything, but a bunch of people keep following us. So follow us on Rumble. Nice. And then,
clever name.
Yeah, use code clever name at Manscaped. We need that. It's like really the only way to support us. Unless you want to interrupt the show with donations, that's the only real other way to support us. And then we'll shave Martin's chest.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go to the website. If you listen to all this, there's a full other shit show before the show. Oh, yeah. Look at his dick. Look at Poncho's dick.
Petscaped.
Petscaped. Look at that dick.
Oh my god.
It's so clean.
I took some pictures.
It's beautiful. So if you want to shave your dog dick or your spouse's dick or your own dick, then get yourself a lawnmower.
4.0.
Not just a regular one. That would get wild. But if you do that, film it and send it. Put it in the Discord. In Primordial's video, you'll find it. Anyway, thanks, everybody. Keep downloading episodes. What did I even just do?
Hey, I'm twice.
Whoa.
Martin, why do you have Martin as a pollock?
You're a self-hating brown and a pollock. I don't even know what just happened.
Oh, there we go.
What?
It's a promo shot.
Oh. Thank you. We switched everything up. So, yeah, keep downloading episodes. Keep using the code. Keep doing everything that supports us. Juice the algorithm. Lie to it. Say slurs. I don't know. Do whatever you want. That's what we're here for. And most of all, keep your shit together.
Hey, yo, it's the clever name podcast. Hey, yo, know when y'all want that clever name podcast. Y'all want that clever name podcast. Y'all want that. Clever name podcast. Y'all want that clever name podcast.
Love that crack cocaine. I love it.